Hello my friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix. On this video tutorial today I'm going to show you how to change the thermal compound for this graphic card. Is Nvidia RX 590, is 8 GB graphic card, and in the same time I'm going to show you how to replace thermal pads for this graphic card. Okay, so this method will work also in your own graphic card. Maybe you don't have the same model, but it will work the same. So let's go directly to the point and let's fix this. We are going to change thermal compound for this graphic card, and in the same time we are going to change thermal pads. I have here three models. Look at this. We have here 0.5 mm. I have here 1 mm, 3 mm pads. Okay, I have all I need. I have also Arctic MX4 thermal compound. It is a very good brand. You will find all the links in the description. I have here digital caliper, and with this digital caliper we will measure pads thickness, and then we will use exact one like this graphic card it needs. And this is very good gaming graphic card. I just bought this used, and I don't know if this one is used for Bitcoin or something like that. Okay, we will make this graphic card like a new. Okay, so we have pads here on the back, we have pads on the front. So as you see, I have here on my table all the screwdrivers that I need, and then I have here my iFixit tool. Let's open up the graphic card right now. Okay, I'm going to remove first of all this front cover. Okay, yes, make sure to remove this pin. You see this one here? We are going to remove this, make sure. Okay, and there is another one here. There is another one here. I'm going to remove this also. This is for the Sapphire light here at the top, okay? You gently remove the connectors if you don't want to damage like I did, okay? Look at this. I did this. So I will fix it later, okay? We have to replace the pads at the back. We have a big pad here. I damaged it a little bit. I removed this and we have to replace it later. Now guys, I will remove these four screws. That this one will lock the radiator tight with the graphic card. So let's remove this one. First one and two. So it's not that hard, guys, as you see, it's not that hard. Gently. Now, look. Look what we have here. This thermal paste here, it's very dry. If you see, it is dry. We have to change and put new one here, you see? And the pads here are dry. We have to put new ones. And we have here some small pads here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to clean it. Okay, well, I'm going to clean this. I'm going to remove one pad here. I want to see how thick it is. Guys, it's 0.5 mm. And let's see now these small ones, how millimeters they are. 0.5 mm. Now I'm going to open up these new pads, 0.5 mm. And I'm going to use it here. It's 0.6 mm, but when I remove the plastic bags, then it will be exactly the same. So now let's cut the pads with the size that we have here. So let's try the first one here. After we put all the thermal pads here on this, on the small areas, you see, and I put all of these others here, and now I will put the thermal paste compound. Let's put this MX4. Okay. So now we are good to go. Let's put the radiator back. And now put back all the screws and make sure you tie them all. Now is the time to change the thermal pad and the back. Let's grab a piece from this.
This one is 1 millimeter. Yes, to make sure it's 1 millimeter. See? Okay. Now, let's cut off 1 millimeter and bring it here. And now is the moment we put the back cover. Don't forget to connect back two connectors, one here and then the other one here at the bottom, and put the cover here. You have to put all the screws now, the small ones here, small ones, you have to put it here. There are some shorter one, okay? The shorter one will be here at the back. Then now we have three more screws, but these are a little bit longer. Now you have to go and test it and write me a comment on a comment area. Let me know how your graphic card will perform after you change all the thermal paste. So thank you guys for watching this video tutorial. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.